With all this free time sitting in my house, what else was I gonna do besides binge watch Netflix shows? Hey, how's it going, guys? My name is Ryan Ramakrishnan. Welcome to this channel where we talk about gaming, TV shows, and films. In March, I literally watched so many shows. Today, I'm going to be talking to you guys about all the shows that I watched on Netflix over the last month, kind of my reactions to them. So without further ado, let's just start talking about some Netflix shows.
Welcome to Key House.
I could never get your father to talk about his life here.
I really enjoyed Lock and Key. I started watching the show around the beginning of March with my dad, and we both got hooked very quickly. Now, unfortunately, with our clashing schedules, it definitely took a couple of weeks to actually finish it, but Lock and Key was definitely on my mind all of the time. I found the story of the show to be very interesting. I'm totally down to check out that source material. I have no prior connection to it, but it is really cool based on what they did with this show. All of the keys and the magic in this show are really cool, and there is just this awesome sense of adventure for the main characters in Lock and Key, and I found them to be pretty good. While some of the high school drama could be a flaw for some viewers, I actually personally saw it enhancing the story more than anything, making it more dramatic and definitely relatable. There are some tense moments that kept me on the edge of my seat by the end of each episode with this show, and honestly, I thought that the use of music was stellar. The story was overall just a lot of fun and really engaging, and I'm definitely looking forward to season 2 of Lock and Key. In the past, I heard good things about you, so I decided to check the show out finally last month. And when I tell you that I was sold from the start, seriously, I really was. I thought that this show was great, specifically because of the cast and characters.
If I just keep being the perfect boyfriend, you'll realize I'm not a maybe. I'm the one.
Joe Goldberg is just so fascinating as a character. He does some really bad, too horrible things. Joe justifies them for the better of others that he loves and cares about. So he is just super interesting because of that, and played to perfection by Penn Badgley. And the supporting cast is all quite excellent too for the most part. I was super engaged in the dramatic stories of Joe and his love and the things that he would do for it. Things got progressively more intense as time went on, and I was never not wondering what was gonna happen next.
It's hard to have a fresh start when the past is on your mind.
Season 1's overall narrative felt more fluid in some ways, but then I also look at the characters, and if you saw my previous video about them, you'll know how much I love them in Season 2 in particular. With that, I can't help but think that Season 2 might be even better. Overall, there are just so many great characters and stories, and it is just a great show. I binged it very quickly, and I'm super excited for Season 3. I had been, and still am, quite far behind on watching Marvel's Netflix shows, despite my adoration for the MCU films. I started Daredevil a little while back, and wrapped up its first season definitely loving it, and at some point after that I began Jessica Jones. Last month I finally finished it. I would say that I basically had about half the season left, and wow, what an intense and well-crafted season that was.
A big part of the job is looking for the worst in people. Turns out I excel at that.
You a PI?
I'm just trying to make a living, you know, boosts cost money. Usually.
I love that this show was just not afraid of going into very dark adult and mature themes. It wasn't afraid to be grounded in reality. It tackled things like abuse and rape in there, and it was just so dark and very dramatic, and things got pretty intense. Jessica Jones is a very well-written show. I thought that Kilgrave was just portrayed perfectly by the charming David Tennant, and he was terrifying as a villain. And the overall storyline was just really interesting to follow. I really like what they did with the character of Jessica Jones, and I really think that the performances from Kristen Ritter were also great. I cannot believe that it took me so long to watch this show, but now I'm definitely ready to continue with this abridged version of the MCU. On My Block is one of my favorite shows. I love the characters of Ruby, Jamal, Monsei, and Caesar. The show is really funny and it has a lot of heart, but also regularly covers some serious issues. And season 3, while feeling a little short, really did continue the trends that made me love the show so much.
Okay, so here's the sitch.
Tell anyone else about the mission threatens our safety.
Cuccio wants you to find little Ricky.
But what do I know?
On My Block's third season carries a lot of weight with the characters and their development. I thought that the show really lets these kids grow, both as themselves and as friends to one another. There was a lot of relationship drama and tension, and the gang life, while arguably a little less exciting than some of the Prophet stuff in season 2, was very thrilling and prominent nevertheless, also pretty sad. And there were of course plenty of good laughs in this season of the show. On My Block season 3 wrapped up with a very nice and emotional ending, really going out with a bang. I enjoyed this season a whole lot, and it was really just good to have it back, and I easily binged it in a day. But now I'm really just missing it again so much because this is a great show that I really recommend. After wrapping up both Big Mouth and BoJack Horseman, I needed another animated show to watch on Netflix. So I stumbled upon F is for Family.
Christ, so how many kids do we have? Back in the old days, the good Lord had the decency to take one or two out with polio. Something to help out!
And in many ways, I really couldn't stop watching this show. F is for Family currently has 3 seasons under its belt, and I watched all of them last month. This show is kind of stupid and ridiculous, but you know, in the best way that you kind of expect with an adult animation like this. But it is actually super funny. I really enjoyed it. I personally got a lot of good laughs regularly from the many things happening with this family. And the show has some pretty good stories too in there, surprisingly. Not that it goes super deep and dramatic, but F is for Family does have some plot lines that are not unreasonable, especially given their satire on American families in the 70s. It had me super entertained, and I actually kind of was engaged with the characters a lot, and I'm glad that I finally checked out this show. F is for Family is going to be getting a 4th season this year, and I'm super excited for it because I think the show is just a good time. I watched the first episode of Ragnarok unaware of it not being American, and I was very interested as I watched that pilot, except the English dub kind of threw me off. Now, I don't really watch a lot of foreign TV or movies. It's not that I don't like to or want to, I really just never have. But I did decide to see Ragnarok's remaining episodes how they were meant to be. So I watched it from episode 2 to 6 in Norwegian. I had my English subtitles on, and the show proved to be very entertaining and interesting for me. I really had no problem following along with the show, and I found myself very engaged. This show has the usual high school tropes like crushes, sex, and bullies, but there's obviously a lot more with Ragnarok. Of course, there's Norse mythology, and there's also some messages about some serious world issues, namely the environment. So the stuff with the environment is sometimes kind of thrown in your face. I think that it made for an interesting storyline, and as you watch it, you'll see the relevance of the characters in there and stuff. I think that the characters are really good in Ragnarok, and I do really like the whole aspect of Norse mythology, gods and giants and whatnot. It wasn't overblown, but I think that season 2 is gonna have some more in there. But I thought there was a lot of good tension and excitement, pretty interesting characters, and a really cool world that we really haven't seen that much of in this short season. Like I said, I was and am very behind on the MCU shows on Netflix. Now I'm finally working on it. And Daredevil season 2 is just so awesome that I'm really disappointed in myself for waiting so long to see it.
The city is ground zero in a war it doesn't even know is happening.
Jon Bernthal, for starters, was just excellent as Frank Castle. And the whole Punisher storyline was intense, proceeding to be really compelling and even emotional. The Punisher is also a character that brings in brutal action, which is always something I want. Obviously, he has a show, and I'm very excited to get there when I get there. I loved what they did with the case and how everything between Matt, Foggy, and Karen went. Their relationships really were tested. This season just did wonderful character development, both individually and as a team, for our main 3 there. I found that all of them really grew, each of them in their own right being the most interesting, well-written, and acted parts of the season. Some of the action scenes were literally just so top tier, having me so thrilled. I really appreciate their choreography with action in this show. Now, I didn't love everything about the Elektra and the hand storylines as much, but I did think it was fulfilling enough that I was definitely interested. I really liked the relationship between Elektra and Matt, and of course, more ninjas just means more fighting, so that is very satisfying. Overall, just a great season to watch with a whole lot of excitement, and I'm definitely looking forward to continuing Daredevil.
Why is no one stopping?
Probably because you've got your tits out. No one stops the weirdos except other weirdos.
Do you want a lift?
Come on.
I am gonna be so fucked off if we get murdered.
I've heard some pretty positive things about the British dark comedy, The End of the Effing World. So I decided to go check it out and see what's good with this show. I found myself engaged from the start, ending up binging both seasons in no time. This show has 20-minute episodes, so it was a very simple binge. The End of the Effing World has just some of the most amazing performances for multiple reasons, probably a little different from other shows, because I found that Jessica Barden and Alex Lawther really did kill it as Alyssa and James respectively. These characters are kind of unique and very distinct in their personalities. Maybe not every actor would be able to pull it off, but these kids, who are not even that young actually, really did make it believable. I bought their performances so much. Alyssa and James, they're not necessarily people I'd want to know, but in the end, I genuinely felt for them. Like, I really had hard emotions for both of them because they are people who just need someone. They need each other. This show has a really good story going on. It goes in some crazy directions. We see that these kids run away from home and they go on this adventure literally wherever the road takes them. It is a dark show for sure, but it is also funny. The end of the effing world manages to make me laugh, but in some ways that is not just so conventional. I like that about dark comedies like this. So I found it really entertaining.
Hey little sister, who's the only one?
Season 2 is probably not as funny, nor as grand in a way, as the first. Yet, the end of the effing world Season 2 is probably more intimate, and things are arguably just a lot more emotional and intense. And I really do think that they delivered on wrapping up the storyline started in Season 1. I really love the show, and despite the fact that I'd be all for more, I think that Season 2 ended perfectly. And now all I could do is just tell you to please go watch the end of the effing world if you haven't already. I've enjoyed a lot of The Simpsons, though certainly can't say all of the 30-some-odd seasons, and Futurama was also a delight, so I was super excited in 2018 to see Matt Groening's next project. Last year, that show, Disenchantment, got its part 2, which I do and will always refer to as Season 2.
You ever have a nightmare and at the last second you wake up and everything's okay? Well, this isn't one of those.
Disenchantment's second season stood up pretty well in accordance with the first, which I did thoroughly enjoy. I really liked Bean, Lucy, and Elfo, amongst others. And I love what they did with them in part 2. What I enjoyed so much about this second half or second season is how things were really shaken up, especially right away, because Dreamland was basically just all stone and Bean had to go live with her mom who had a lot of secrets, and Bean was basically just gonna go on another crazy adventure after another. Once we got the main players like Lucy and Elfo back, things just got to be more fun. There's a lot of funny moments and adventures and really eccentric and random crazy characters, a lot of jokes, and some of them are super clever and witty, and it's just a charming show, and I always have a good time watching Disenchantment. I think Disenchantment is just a good time, and I do think that if you like the first part and you haven't yet watched part 2, there's no reason not to, because you're gonna get a good sense of entertainment and joy out of it, probably just as much, if not more, than you did in the first part. The final Netflix show that I watched in March was Russian Doll.
Didn't you get the news? We're about to die.
It doesn't matter. I die all the time.
This show came out last year, and I heard some really positive things about this Groundhog Day-like story, and that kind of narrative always catches my attention. I decided to give it a shot. I was especially happy with the short episode length because, you know, that means I got to binge it in a day, and I literally sat on my couch for a few hours, watched the entirety of this first season, and I love the entirety of this first season because it is just full of great things. I loved what Natasha Lyonne did with this character of Nadia and the story of the show overall. Russian Doll has a lot of fun with some entertaining characters and jokes, but it also keeps you on the edge of your seat. I think that the latter is especially true in the second half of the show when things really do pick up. Russian Doll had me very interested in just how the time loop was working for Nadia in the world of this show, especially as opposed to other stories of this nature. And once Russian Doll decided to introduce us to Alan, I was even more engaged as he was probably just as good of a character as Nadia, who I loved. I found them to have a very interesting dynamic, and the show succeeded on its reliance on themes like mental health, friendship, love, closure, and letting go of things. It is a super well-written, smart, deep, and funny show, a very entertaining narrative that really had me hooked from start to finish, and it left me with the biggest smile on my face as I consumed that final episode. This final episode does some awesome things you will just have to see. Alright guys, I'm gonna wrap things up here because those are all the shows that I watched on Netflix in March. So this month I have several other shows that are on my backlog, if you will, that I'm gonna check out. Probably Ozark, Castlevania, Money Heist, Paradise PD, I don't know. There's just so many shows on Netflix that I haven't seen yet, so leave me your recommendations. Maybe I've seen them already, but just leave them and we'll talk about some shows on Netflix. So thank you guys so much for watching. Also comment below your thoughts on the shows that I did talk about and whether you feel the same way about them or not. So anyway, guys, consider subscribing if you want. I mean, ring the notification bell to get notified about future content. I should have another video coming pretty soon. I mean, I have enough free time. So thanks again, guys. I'll see you all in the next video.